The MTS SecureTeserve software includes a suite of applications to assist security officers to carry out regular duties in the most efficient way. Patrol Master is the application where pre-planned patrols, beats, tasks or similar regular checks are found. The following short video explains how the MTS Patrol Master application works in a typical mobile patrolling and key-holding response scenario. After signing on to the handset, you can access the Patrol Master application from the main console by tapping the Patrols icon. Please note, each console is different from site to site as all MTS solutions can be easily configured to suit the individual requirements of the site and contract. From the Patrol's home screen, you can either restart a patrol that has been temporarily stopped by selecting it from the list and double-tapping it, or you can highlight a patrol and delete it from the list by tapping the delete icon at the bottom of the screen, or you can start a new patrol, task or check by tapping the new patrol. Having tapped new patrol, you will then see the various different types of patrols, task or checks. In this example, there are several different options, including checks, patrols, training and beats. The MTS Patrol Master application has been designed to give the ultimate flexibility to cater for all types of sites, tasks, checks and duties, and provides you with the ability to have an unlimited number of patrols, tasks, checks and duties, with an unlimited number of subcategories. In this example, if the user chooses to commence a patrol, there are more than 6 patrol routes to select from, as can be seen by the next and back icons on the screen. If only one page of categories is available, there is no next button. If there are more pages of options when you are on the selected page, then the next and back buttons are displayed, as can be seen from the second screen. Alternatively, if they choose to carry out a training task, they are then given only 4 options of which task they wish to carry out, and therefore there is no next button displayed. If there were only one option, then the user would not see this screen and the application would navigate automatically to the single route or subcategory available. Having chosen the option from the list, the user will be asked if they are accompanied or not. The default is no, but if the user selects yes, they will be asked to type the identity of the person who is accompanying them. Once the selection has been made, the user can tap the start icon to commence. To cancel and start again, tap the abort icon. Once you tap start, the checks will be loaded. In this case, you can see there are 4 checks in total. Having loaded the checks, you are ready to start. The system can be configured to auto-load the checks in the order which they are to be completed, or it will allow the checks to be done in any order. If the user can do the checks in any order they wish, the flashing cursor will be in the white box which is above the last scan box, whereas if the cursor is in the white box at the bottom of the page, you can only scan the checkpoint barcode for the location or details that are shown in the location field. In some examples, you will be carrying out a task which requires further checks or patrols to be done when you arrive at a particular checkpoint. For example, when carrying out a mobile patrol, you may be required to visit a specific site, and once on site, carry out a new patrol or check. If this is the case, the system will automatically stop the existing patrol or beat when you hit the checkpoint, and will advance to the new patrol for that location, as can be seen from this example. The user was carrying out the training beat 2. And has arrived at the site 1 checkpoint, and the system has automatically selected the training patrol 2 patrol. From here, you tap start to commence or abort to cancel. After tapping start, the patrol checkpoints will be loaded and you can commence the patrol. In order to check the progress of the patrol, please tap the grid icon, and all points that have been completed are shown in green, with those to be completed in gray. From here, you can tap random to continue to hit any checkpoint in any order, or tap the checkpoint number if you wish to continue from that checkpoint. If you wish to stop the patrol, you can do so by tapping stop and entering a reason. This will stop the patrol and you can resume it later. In this example, the user has tapped check 2 in the grid. If the user hits checkpoint 2, it will make a sound like this. Auto advance to the next checkpoint. If the wrong checkpoint is hit, it will make a sound like this. Once all checkpoints have been hit, the system will show the grid with all points checked in green. Tap the finished icon to submit the patrol. Some patrols require a signature at the end before submitting. Sign on the screen, then tap the submit icon. Once submitted, you will get this message. Tap OK to continue. Once you have submitted the patrol, you will be returned to the duty that you were doing, and you can restart the stop beat or patrol that you were doing. The system will show you the grid, and you can either select any of the gray checkpoints by tapping the relevant checkpoint, or you can select the random icon to continue in any order you wish. You will then be asked if you wish to restart. Tap yes to continue or no to return to the list. At any time you can submit a patrol as incomplete. If you wish to submit a patrol as incomplete, for example if you are called away or there is restricted access, you can submit an incomplete patrol at any time by tapping the finished icon from the patrol grid, and you will be prompted to confirm that you wish to submit an incomplete patrol, asked to give your reason for submitting an incomplete patrol. Once you have chosen the reason from the list, you will sign and then tap submit. Most options do not require further explanation, some request further details. If you have completed all outstanding patrols, when you return to the list, your list will be empty. From here you can either start a new patrol, or you can tap the exit icon, which will take you back to the home console. From here you can select the patrols icon for patrols, the incidents icon to allow you to report or update an incident, go to settings, or tap the apps icon to access more of the MTS applications. There are several MTS applications available. In this example, we'll see as which is the management visits application, Gmaster, which is our key management and monitoring system, Parking Assist for managing staff and visitor parking and movements, POI, which allows you to map and name certain points of interest, Messages, which is the dedicated in-application messaging system, Lost and Found, which allows you to manage lost property movements.